Hey everybody, Jeremy from AltRider, and we're gonna do the front rotor guard installation for the KTM, and this will fit the 2016 KTM models all the way up to current, as well as the current Husky and Gas models. What you receive with your package, of course you'll get your full rotor guard in the packaging. Let's take a look at the tools necessary. So you're gonna need a 17 millimeter to take the axle retaining bolts off, as well as an M10 to take off the, or loosen, the front fork pinch bolts on the axle. You're gonna want a drift or a punch to get your wheel spacer out, especially if it's a fresh bike. That bearing seal is gonna be holding onto the wheel spacer. While we've got our front axle off, always a great opportunity to clean things up and then re-lube. A waterproof grease is a great idea, especially if your bike's not well maintained. This is a great chance to inspect that front axle and clean it up if you've got any oxidation on there. Of course, you guys are gonna wanna get the bike up on a stand so that we can take the front wheel off. And we'll need a number 4 Allen to set the Loctite on our rotor guard. We're gonna grab the 17 millimeter wrench, and we're gonna take the axle retaining bolt out, right? So before I've undone any of the pinch bolts, I'm gonna take this bolt out. So then I'm gonna go ahead and loosen up all 4 of my axle pinch bolts. Our axle should come out fairly effortless. We should need to use a drift or a hammer, unless it hasn't been maintained and there's oxidation. So I just lift up, and it helps, a little tip guys, if you take a little bit of the load off the wheel, that'll allow that front axle to come sliding right out. And then so right away, I'll go ahead and grab my rag and clean up this front axle. This bike's in really good shape. I don't see any corrosion on there, nothing. It's very smooth. But if you did have any corrosion, this is the time to clean it up, because this should slide in and out of the wheel spacers effortlessly, as well as the fork tubes. So I'll go ahead now, just to prep, put a nice film of fresh grease, and you only need a slight amount, guys. This is also another great time to clean out the aggregate that gets loaded into the axle retaining bolt, and that's because, guys, this is just a really soft aluminum, and we want to, just to take care of the bike, you want to get rid of all of that aggregate, because when it gets driven in, when we go to tighten it back up, that aggregate's going to really eat that aluminum. Get in the habit to protect these, especially on the trail. Don't let these drop down in the mud or whatever and then go to put them right back on. And additionally, of course, if you're riding off-road, this is a time, if you've got, you may not be able to get your socket onto here because you've had some big gashes. So you might want to take a file, and nice and easy by hand, guys, you're just really just taking the burr off in case any of the gouges are keeping you from being able to get your socket or your axle wrench on your axle. Now that we've got everything set, I can go ahead and pull my front wheel, and we just need to pull out this wheel spacer. Get your drift set up, make sure you're at the right angle. We're just grabbing the inside edge, and we're gonna just do light taps because you do not wanna hit this hard enough to put a burr or any sort of mark on there. So I'm just grabbing my ratchet and using that to just drive this, and there it's already come all the way out. So a good opportunity to clean this up, and actually I'll go ahead and reset that with grease. As I can see, I've got a little bit of contaminant in there. And then I'm gonna do this real quick and then just pack some grease in there. Got that all cleaned up, and I'm gonna take the opportunity, because we are in the Pacific Northwest, to just pack that void. It's not necessary for the bearing, because of course it's a sealed bearing, but my theory has always been, if that void is packed with grease, it can't hold water, even if you're gonna pressure wash the bike. So just a habit I get into. Now let's prep our front rotor guard. We wanna just take a moment to Loctite these two fasteners. So I'm gonna do 2 or 3 drops with the resealable bottle of Loctite that I was given. We'll get those in, and I'll go ahead and get these tightened down. We're ready to install our rotor guard. And again, guys, pretty straightforward. I'm just gonna make sure I'm driving that in nice and laterally, or you know, perpendicular or parallel to the axis. And then just 2 taps, and that means I'm seated, so that I'm on the inside of that seal that that's what we were just driving it out and off of, is that rubber seal. Wanted to make sure that that's seated onto there. And now we're ready to install. Before you're resetting that axle, is grab yourself any device to open up the pads. And it's okay if you mar your brake pads, that's not gonna make a difference. But the one thing is to make sure that there's not grease or any sort of contaminant, as you don't wanna get any grease or contaminant on the actual braking surface. Because you actually can have, as happening here, there's dirt that's been loaded up in the seams there. And so now that the axle's out, that aggregate or sand wants to fall out of that crack and into there. So just a nice little step, because I'm gonna be putting that greased axle on, it would just pull it forward. You guys are all aware, but taking 1 second to explain this concept to you, that you've got a shouldered axle here. This shoulder, we're gonna suck it up to against that wheel spacer when we tighten up that axle bolt. And then we'll reset the pinch bolts and allow the forks to go parallel. So I'll explain that in 1 second here. All I'm going to do is just watch to make sure that my wheel spacers pass through here and that I get into my brake pads. And just like I say with the rear, it's always a nice little trick is to use your boot to help hold your front wheel up a little bit. And then I'll reach over here and grab my axle. And for sure, guys, this should all slide in nice and easy. And it's happened to all of us where it all of a sudden it doesn't go easily. Just stop and take a moment. Something's binding up. So I'm just going to make sure I line up over onto the other side. And then I've just got to get past that stepped portion of that axle. And then it'll go the last bit of the way. And there we have it. And just tap that all the way over. Now that I've got my axle set, I'm going to just snug down one of these pinch bolts. That allows me to do my tightening of the axle retaining bolt. It is not an axle nut, it's an axle retaining bolt. I'll get this guy on, and I'll go ahead and torque him to spec, which is 35 Newton meters. But now I'm gonna come back over, I'm gonna loosen up, and you'll even probably see that movement just ever so slightly. But now I'm gonna wanna tighten this side, because I know that this is already seated fully, right? We've done that compression. So I'm gonna seat this side of the fork so he cannot move. And these get torqued to 15 Newton meters. And then you wanna walk into that because it's a clamping force, just like your triple trees. I go 15 Newton meters, click, 15 Newton meters, click, 15 Newton meters, click, 15 Newton meters, click. And you keep going back and forth until the bolts are no longer moving. And now you have them at equal force. But as you guys can see here, you guys see that fork right now is floating. And all we want to do is just ensure that the fork tubes are absolutely parallel, because you can imagine it's pretty easy for that to get off just a little bit. You see how easy it is to move. And if it's off just a little bit, now as the forks try to travel through their stroke, they're no longer parallel. So if they're not parallel, they can't smoothly travel through their stroke, and you're gonna end up with stiction and a very harsh front end. So this is a really simple step to ensure that my fork tubes are parallel. Again, guys, this fork is free to float, so I'm gonna take it off the stand. I'm gonna repump up my front brake, because of course we pushed our pads out, and I want a handful of heavy stroke movements really ensures that the fork tubes are parallel, and now, as long as I don't disturb it again, I can now come back to the pinch bolts and tighten those down. And so no need to put it back on the stand. I'll now snug these up to 50 Newton meters, going from one bolt to the next bolt to the next bolt until they're both at that equal torque spec. And now that ensures that my fork tubes are dead parallel, and I've got everything tightened to spec. Hey, thanks everybody for joining us. I hope you guys learned something. And thanks for supporting AltRider. We're proud to be an American-based company, and that all the products are designed by real riders. We really pride ourselves in that fact, as well as we make a conscious effort to staff the customer service. So if you need any support or you've got questions, please reach out to us. And thanks again for your time.